Hey guys, hi, welcome back. So in the previous video, we have completed the lectures related to the Fourier series, right? So we will see the questions of different examinations. We will not get that many questions of Fourier series in competitive exams, but whatever it is, let's solve the questions of GATE 2013 first. So the first question is, fx is a symmetric function. That means f of minus x, it is equals to fx. Symmetric function, that means it's an even function. So in general, the Fourier series of the function fx will be of the form. You will have to just tell the Fourier series expansion for an even function. So you know, for an even function, we write fx is equals to a naught plus summation n is equals to 1 to infinity an cos nx, right? That means you will have only the dc term and the cosine term. The sine term is not there. Bn is equals to 0 for even function. So if you see out of the four options, it has bn, it is also having bn, it is also having it. So the correct option is option B. Clear? Now let's see the next question. So here what it is said, a periodic function fx of period 2 pi, all right? It is defined in the interval x is greater than minus pi, less than pi. You have a function fx whose period is 2 pi. It is defined in the interval for x greater than minus pi, but less than pi. So fx is equals to minus 1 for x greater than minus pi, but less than 0. And it is equals to 1 for x greater than 0, less than pi. So you will have to find the appropriate Fourier series expansion of the function fx. So it's clear, you will have to just find the Fourier series expansion. So if you see the function, it is an odd function, right? If you take minus of this term, function fx, it will become 1. If you take this minus, it will become minus 1. That is, you can say fx is equal to minus of fx, right? So it is an odd function. So for this reason, what you will do, you will write a naught is equal to 0 and also an is equal to 0, right? For an odd function, you will have to calculate only bn. So bn, it is equal to what? You will write it to be 1 by pi, okay? It's 2 by b minus a. So the period is given to you, right? 2 by, it is what? 2 pi, so pi and pi will get cancelled. And here you will have what? From a to b. So it is minus 1 here. So you will have here what? Minus pi to 0, right? And here you will have what? Sine nx dx. Clear? Next, again, you will write plus. Here you will have what? 0 to pi. And this is 1. This is sine nx dx. Clear? So just to the integration, this is 1 by pi. Minus sine is there. Keep the minus as it is. When you will integrate sine, you will get what? Minus of cos nx divided by n. All right? And the integration limit will be here, minus pi to 0, okay? Plus, again, you will get here what? Minus cos nx by n. And this is 0 to pi, all right? So if you do 1 by pi here, and if you take n common outside, this will become minus and minus plus, right? So you will have what? Cos 0 minus cos n pi, all right? Again, if you take minus here, outside, and here you will have what? Cos n pi minus cos 0. Alright, this is what you will have. So if you see here, cos 0 value is what? 1. Cos n pi is what? Minus 1 to the power n. This is again what? Minus 1 to the power n. This is what? 1. Right? This is this way. So you will write, finally, you will get bn, it is equals to 1 by pi n. All right. So first you were having what? Cos 0. So it is 1 minus cos n pi minus 1 to the power n. Again, minus was there. Okay. It was cos n pi positive. So minus 1 to the power n. Again, minus, minus plus. You can see here. This is what? Minus and minus a plus. Okay. So it will be what? 1. All right. So if you see here, you will get it to be what? 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. So 2 by pi n, and here you will have what? 1 minus minus of 1 to the power n. This is the value of bn, okay? So when you see when n is what? Odd. When n will be odd, bn will be equals to what? 4 by pi n. You can see minus and minus will become plus, 2 to the 4. And when n is even, then you will get bn is equals to what? 0. Clear? Therefore, you can write the function fx is equal to what? Summation n is equal to 1 to infinity bn sine and x. So you will get for even terms, there will be no terms. Only for odd you will have. So for bn equals to what? 1 you will have 4 by pi. Okay. Here you will have what? Sine x. Clear? Again you will write plus for odd term. You will have 1 by 3, right? For n equals to 3, here you will have what? Sine 3x. Okay. 4 by pi will be in all the terms. So this will give you what? Sine 5x by 5 and so on. So you will see what is the answer. The correct answer is option A. 4 by pi sine x plus sine 3x by 3 plus sine 5x by 5 and so on. Clear? So now let's see question number 3. This question is from Jess. So here it says the function fx is equals to cos hyperbolic x and it is existing in the range for x greater than minus pi but less than pi. And it is periodically repeated between x is equals to 2m minus 1 pi to 2m plus 1 pi. M is standing from minus infinity to plus infinity. So using the Fourier series, you will have to indicate the relation at x equals to 0. That means first you will have to find the Fourier series expansion and then you will have to deduce the relation at x equals to 0. Right? So you're having the function cos hyperbolic x. We know here if you see f of minus x, it will be equals to f of x. So that's an even function. So when we are talking about the even function, we know the bn is equals to 0. That means the sine term are not available. Okay, it is not there. So you will have to calculate only a naught and an. So you know a naught is equals to what? You will write a naught will be equals to, you can write it to be 1 by 2 pi. Okay, integration 0 to, sorry, minus pi to pi. And this you will have what? Cos hyperbolic x. All right. So when you will do so, from this, this is minus pi to pi. So make the limit to be what? 2 by 2. Make it 0 to pi. So you will have 2. So you will have here 1 by pi. Cos hyperbolic x dx. All right. And you will get a naught is equals to what? It will give you, here it will be pi. And when you will do integration of cos hyperbolic x, you will get sine hyperbolic x. When you will put the upper limit, you will have sine hyperbolic pi. Lower limit will give you 0. So this is the value of a naught, right?
So now we will calculate an. An is equals to what? Same thing, 2 by pi. Integration limit will be what? Integration will be 0 to pi, right? 0 to pi. The function is cos hyperbolic x, cos nx dx. So if you see cos hyperbolic x, it is what? E to the power x plus e to the power minus x, all right, divided by 2. So it will give you 1 by pi, integration 0 to pi, e to the power x, cos nx you can write plus e to the power minus x cos nx. All right, this is dx. So we have a formula e to the power ax cos bx dx. It is equal to what? E to the power ax by a square plus b square. And here you will have what? Cos bx plus a sine cos bx plus b sine bx. Okay, so if you see here from this term, a is equals to 1, e to the power ax, that means it is a is equals to 1 and b is equals to n. So it is 1 by pi, okay? So it will be what? E to the power x. A square is what? 1. B square is n. So it is n square plus 1. And you will have here what? Cos bx, right? B is what? N. So it is cos nx plus a is equals to 1, okay? Now b. B will be what? N sine nx. Okay, plus similarly it will be e to the power minus x, again 1 plus n square. Okay, this time your a is equals to what? Minus 1, right? So it is minus cos nx, and here you will have what? Plus b is equals to n, so n sine nx. Clear? Integration limit will be same, 0 to pi. This is 0 to pi.
All right, so it is 1 by pi. Okay, taking outside n square plus 1. Okay, in both from both the terms. So you will write it equals to what? This is what? E to the power pi, putting the upper limit. Okay, again, this will give you cos n pi. All right, putting the upper limit. Now you will put the lower limit. Lower limit means what? Minus e to the power 0 cos 0. Okay, for this term it's done. Now we will do for the second term. So if you see for the sine term, sine n pi and sine 0, these are what? Zero. So you will not put for this.
again we will do for the other one. So if you see here, it's minus, okay? So I'm keeping the minus sign outside and I'm taking just cos n pi. So when you will put the upper limit, you will write it what? E to the power minus pi, okay? Minus a, this is e to the power minus pi, okay? Because you are having what? Minus x. And here you will have what? Cos n pi, okay? Next is e to the power 0 is 1, and you will have what? Minus, you will have what? Cos 0. All right? So you can write 1 by pi n square plus 1. So after taking common, you will see this is e to the power pi, okay? Cos n pi. Cos n pi means what? Minus 1 to the power n. All right? This will give you what? Minus e to the power 0 and cos 0. Cos 0 is what? 1. So you will get it to be equals to what? 1. And here if you see, this is minus e to the power minus pi minus 1 to the power n. This will give you again what? Plus 1. Right? So if you see this plus 1, minus 1 will get cancelled. You will have what? 1 by pi n square plus 1. If you take e to the power pi minus e to the minus pi out here, and if you take minus 1 to the power n common. So if you see here, you know e to the power x minus e to the power minus x by 2. It is what? Sine hyperbolic x. So you can write a n is equals to what? You can write it equals to 2 sine hyperbolic pi, right? Divided by pi n square plus 1. And here you can write minus 1 to the power n, right? So this is the value of a n. So finally, if you see here, you will write the function fx is equals to what? A naught plus summation n is equals to 1 to infinity. It is a n cos nx dx. You got a naught was equals to what? A naught was equals to sine hyperbolic pi by pi. And a n you got, it was 2 minus 1 to the power n pi 1 plus n square summation n is equals to 1 to infinity. This is sine hyperbolic pi, right? And this is cos nx dx. Clear? So fx is what? Fx can be written as cos hyperbolic x. This is the function. So at x equals to 0, what you will write? This will be what? 1. Here you will have sine hyperbolic pi by pi, okay? And plus you will have summation n is equals to 1 to infinity, 2 minus 1 to the power n, pi 1 plus n square. This is sine hyperbolic pi. This term will be what? 1, okay? So take this term to the left-hand side. You will have 1 minus sine hyperbolic pi by pi, okay? Plus, sorry, it's equal to n is equals to 1 to infinity, 2 minus 1 to the power n, pi 1 plus n square, sine hyperbolic pi. Okay, so if you see here, you can write taking this term as summation n is equals to 1 to infinity, minus 1 to the power n, 1 plus n square. Keeping just this term, rest term pi by 2, okay, sine hyperbolic pi, taking it to the other side, you will have 1 minus sine hyperbolic pi by pi. Right, this is what you will have. So finally you can write it equals to what? If you take this term pi sine hyperbolic pi inside, you will have 1 by 2, right? And here you will have what? This will become 1 and this will become what? This will give you what? Pi by sine hyperbolic pi, okay? And here you will have what? Minus 1, right? This is what you will have, 1 by 2. Pi sine hyperbolic pi minus 1. So you will get summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n by 1 plus n square. It is equals to this term. So this is the relation that you will get. Okay, summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n by 1 plus n square. It is equals to half within the bracket you are having pi sine hyperbolic pi minus 1. So you will see the correct option is what? The correct option will be summation n is equals to 1 to infinity. So first two options are not correct. You can see the last option. Summation n is equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n by 1 plus n square is equals to half into with pi by sine hyperbolic pi minus 1. Clear? So don't get confused when you see the questions are complicated, because the just questions are seem complicated, but they are very easy when you solve. Clear? Thank you so much. Have a good day.